Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this timeline in Canva. So the first thing I want to do on my homepage is go to create a design. And then from the selection, you can just simply scroll down and choose any of these options. I'm going to go to invitation because as you can see, it is a square. And the first thing I'm going to do is enter in some graphics. I'm going to go to elements. Then in the search bar here, I'm just going to type in 3D pyramid gradient. Now you can select any image of choice, any graphic of choice, but I'm going to type that in, press enter, and then I'm going to go down to graphics here and click on see all. And then I'm going to scroll down to this one here. Anything with a crown on is the pro version, which you'll have to pay for, but I'm going to choose this free option here and click. Once that's inserted, I'm just going to resize it, pull it down to the bottom here, and for my timeline I'm simply going to enter in all of my information for one, and then I'm going to copy and paste it. So the next is the text, so I'm going to go to text here and then click on any of these you like. I'm just going to click and drag over this one and then put in my text, and then I'm going to just simply click and drag across all of the text. I'm going to change the font, and this time I'm going to select something called Cooper Hewitt, this one here, and I'm going to change the font size. Let's take that down, probably about there. I'm going to take the bold off, and I'm just going to move that across. There we go. Deselect the box, reselect it, and go to this duplicate box there, duplicate that text box. So now all I'm going to do is go and grab some more text. So I'm going to copy and paste some text in. I'm sure you don't want to watch me type it all out. Double click inside. I'm just going to paste mine in. Now this text is too big, so all I need to do is adjust the size of the box. And Canva will actually do the work for me by reducing the size of the text. So my text is going to be about this big. Once again, I'm going to select this text box and then duplicate it again. We're going to take that down to the bottom. And here we're going to put in the year. This one I'm going to put into bold. If you double click inside, Command or Control A will select all of the text, and then go to bold. And this is where you can select from your colors. So if we go down to this shape here and click on it, you can see at the top here, we've got a range of colors. You can select from these colors for your text. If I click on this text here and go to the text color icon, you can see the colors appear in document colors. It's identified the colors in your shape. So I'm going to select this darker pink, and I'm going to do the same at the top here with this text as well. So once I'm relatively happy with where things are, we need to just make sure they're aligned. So I'm going to select all of those by clicking and dragging across, go to position, and then I'm going to make sure they're all centered. Now you can see that centered is grayed out. That actually means they're all perfectly centered up. And that's usually because Canva does a really good job of centering things for you. When you move it across, they will click into place. So once you're happy with it, where everything lies, we're going to duplicate it. So I'm just going to move this down a little bit. I'm just going to make that a little bit smaller. Again, line that back up. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select it all, and I'm going to select group. Once I've grouped it together, I can duplicate the whole group, as you can see, and I'm going to simply go ahead and duplicate that 5 times. Now this is a really good time to space everything out. So you can see the gap over this side, and if things are a little bit too tight, we can move them over slightly, but then we can select them all. Then again, we can click on more, space evenly, and then we can go to horizontal. That will ensure there's an equal space between everything. And then if you want to make sure it's all lined up to the top, you can go to align. And again, the top is grayed out because it's all perfectly aligned. Now you can leave the alignment like that, or you can select this group here, select the whole group. Sometimes you have to click on the outside to select the whole group. Then hold down your shift key. Let's select that group again. hold down your shift key and select this group here. And then you can just use your arrow key and move those two groups up just to give a little bit more interest. You don't have to do this step, but I think it adds a nice bit of interest to your timeline. Once you've done that, we can select everything. We can group it together, go to position, and then click center. And there, everything is perfectly centered. Let's go to ungroup. To add a little bit more interest, we can go ahead and change the colors. So let's click on this pyramid here, go up to shapes, and click on one of the colors. And here you can select any other colors. So let's select a blue, and then for this color here, let's select slightly different blue, this color here, a lighter blue, and then we can leave the yellow if you want to, or you can change that as well. Again, going to the text, select the text, go to color, and then again, you can select one of the colors from your pyramid. I'm going to go ahead and do that with the next three and speed up the video. So once you've completed that step and you're happy with the alignment, select everything and then group it together. Once you've grouped everything in Canva, you can easily change the size of everything, which is really useful, and none of it distorts or loses any kind of quality. So let's just move this down so we can get a title in at the top. Okay, let's enter in the title. So let's go to text, then click add heading. There we go. And then we can just move this around. Once again, we can change anything of this timeline. So deselect it, reselect it, make sure the cursor's not inside, then you can customize your text. Select the box, let's go up to color, maybe choose a color. And you can also underline it as well if you choose to. And then we'll go to position, make sure it's centered, deselect. I'm gonna move that title just down a little bit with my arrow key. Perfect. The final thing we need to do is to put in a background. And the really easy way to do this is a gradient. So if we go to elements and then across the top here, let's just type in gradients. And you can select from all of the gradients. Obviously the free ones don't have the crown. I'm going to select this one here, click and drag it across. Then I'm just going to stretch it out across my canvas. And then once it's selected, I'm going to go to position. And then I'm going to go to two back. And then because it's a little bright, I'm going to go up to the transparency slider here. I'm just going to take down that transparency. Perfect. Once you're finished, just go to share. And then you can go to download. And then you simply have a choice of different files. Once you've chosen your file, just click download. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.